Hi guys, I'm Lena, welcome to my channel and welcome to the Kungur city, one of the eldest city in not only Perm region, but in all the Ural district. And as you may see, this city is not spoiled or destroyed with the crowds of tourists. So if you want to discover this city with me, maybe we will be the only two tourists. In the Cathedral Square is an obelisk made of grey marble in honor of the defenders of Kungur from the troops of Pugachev in 1774. Later, in the Soviet times, the monument was renamed in honor of Pugachev and Peasant War, which is absolutely vice versa. Instead of a double-headed eagle, a red star was installed. In 2000, it was restored to its original appearance, meaning and name. Cast iron cannons are installed next to the monument. The exact date of the foundation of Kungur is not known for certain. More precisely, there is a debate about what is considered the foundation of Kungur. The year 6048 is generally accepted, so let's consider it the same. According to one version, the name of the city came from the Turkic word Unkur or Ungur, cave, grove, gap in the rocks. According to another version, the name translates as dark brown. And this is actually was the main pedestrian zone of the city center with various of cafeteria, restaurants and sea signs. But now we can see the renovation, so that's why I will put the photos. Kungur became a large merchant center because the Siberian road began to pass through it and the Silva River used to be navigable, an important trading road. Merchants Губкины, Кузнецовы, Грибушины carried tea from China in carts. I'm not sure that the names will tell you anything, but believe me, they were the largest merchants. By the way, it is Губкин who first began to sell tea by weight and then began to pack it in small beautiful packages. So, and we now are at the very city center of the Kungur, and you can observe the monument of the people of the Ural district who took the initiative of creating the Ural Volunteer Tank Corps. And I want to introduce you the historian, the museum employee, and my very good friend Дмитрий Лобанов.
В начале войны в Кунгур было эвакуировано Киевское танковое училище. Оно находилось здесь неподалеку, готовили командиров экипажей. Кстати, когда формировался корпус, он формировался, значит, первоначальное обучение как раз проходило на базе этого училища, на танкодроме училища. Многие выпускники училища вышли, стали офицерами Уральского добровольчества танкового корпуса. Ну, вот такая связь с Кунгуром.
By the way, this three-story building of the former city council, built in the early 1820s in the classicist style at the expense of burghers and merchants. And now you look to Gostiny Dvor, which is built in the tradition of classicism. This is the main symbol of merchant Kungur. Along the perimeters of this building, shops were located. Through large arches one could pass into the courtyard, where trade was also conducted. So, one of the things which Kungur is famous for is aviation, and this little guy maybe was the first self-aviator, and actually it is a very sad story. According to legend, the boy Nikita, who handmade the artificial wings, was the first Russian conqueror of the sky. However, on the orders of Ivan the Terrible, Google him or wait for my new video, the teenager was executed so that no one dares even dream of flying into the sky. This monument is in honor of all intrepid romantics, all aspiring to the heights, even if the government limits you. On the pedestal of the monument, pledges or medallions are installed with the names of the winners of the aeronautic competitions, which were held every summer before the pandemic at the festival Sky Fair of the Urals. It is believed that if you make a wish and drop the cast iron heel of Nikita, the dream will come true. But of course I won't do that.
If you're interested wearing Kungur, you can very cheap to eat. I can recommend such places where you can buy coffee for only half a euro. Italian cappuccino for a half an euro. Yeah, and that's true. And I think that at the Kungur there are plenty of such places. So, welcome here.
And maybe one of the most recognizable features of Kungur city is this temple, this cathedral, in the honor of the Tikhvinskaya Ikona Божьей Матери. And if you want to have a look on all the city area, and even for the river, you have to climb at the very top of this cathedral. On the territory of the historical and landscape complex Voznesensky Necropolis, there is a memorial to the soldiers of the Czechoslovak Corps who died during the Civil War. The monument is made in the form of wagon Tiplushka, in which they moved through Russia. I have no idea how to translate Tiplushka, I'd better explain you. It is covered good wagon, which was reconstructed, converted, for the transportation of people or horses, as usual armed forces in Russia. The memorial is engraved with the names of 121 Czechoslovak soldiers who died in the area of the city of Kungur in villages Shamary, Kyn, Kuzina and Kardon. The most famous object in Kungur is of course the ice cave, the miracle of nature. It has 48 grottos, 70 lakes. This is one of the largest karst caves in Europe, which is at least 10-12,000 years old. And in March, if everything goes well, I'll show it for you. At the end or at the entrance to the Kungur, it depends, you can see this interesting and a little bit weird monument. The monument has controversial artistic merits. To be completely honest, you can scare children with it. Kungur is shown as old craftsman, who in one hand holds a cornucopia depicted on the coat of arms of the city, and in other a stalagmite, a symbol of the ice cave. On the sculpture you can see a relief figure of a bear, a symbol of Permeridion, and below three waves symbolizing the rivers Silva, Irene and Shakwa. Thank you so much for joining me in this journey to the Kungur city. It was Lena and my unforgettable Russian accent. Please subscribe to my channel and see you next time, maybe in the next city of Permeridion.